This video is sponsored by LoomCube and the new RGB light that they just released called the Panel Pro. So when it comes to cheap gear and very expensive gear, the Great Equalizer in quality costs about $100. Learning how to use this lighting tool will elevate your work instantly and bring the best out of your camera. Let me show you how it's done. I'm gonna show you how to take some professional portraits using my cheap camera, only one flash, and a cheap $20 umbrella. I'm gonna go over the gear specifics and the settings that I used later on in the video. So let's start with the most important part, light position. I made a whole video on this topic and I highly recommend you check it out. I'll leave a link down below. But personally, I think light looks best when it comes from a 45 degree angle, slightly angled down towards the model. Things that you need to have on point. You want to have it as close as possible so that you can get the softest light quality. And you want to make sure that you have a catch light in the eye. That's a reflection of the umbrella in the eye. If you don't get that, you have to make adjustments until you do. I'm going to show you that changing the model's distance from the background will make a huge difference in the outcome. First, let's put her up against the white backdrop. When you do this, you are going to be capturing the shadow right next to her in the photo. Depending on your personal taste, you may or may not like this look. I personally think it looks okay. When you ask the model to take a couple steps away from the background, I would say around a foot away, you're gonna be getting a softer, more pleasant shadow fall off onto the backdrop. And in my opinion, it looks better than when she was up against the wall. Now, when you ask the model to stand about 4 feet away from the backdrop or the wall that you're using, you're gonna be eliminating her shadow from the photo. And unlike a more directional light source, an umbrella is spreading the light in every direction, and you're gonna be getting a nice, soft gradient of light on the background. In my opinion, this one looks best, but none of these are bad. It just depends on the look that you want for your photo. Okay, since we're on the topic of lighting, do you see that nice purple kicker light that I got going on here? Let me tell you about this new RGB light that LoomCube just released. It's called the Panel Pro, and it's the largest light panel in their lineup currently, and it produces some really nice soft light. This is a very slim and portable RGB light designed for photographers and videographers. This RGB light gives you 360 color options with a color temperature range from 3000K to 5700K. It has some creative modes for video, like it emulates what a siren would look like, a fire, and lightning. It weighs 200 grams, has 4-quarter thread mounting options, and has a really long-lasting battery. This light is Bluetooth compatible, and using the LoomCube app, you'll be able to control as many of these panels as you want, all while being able to tweak your color and settings from your phone. Just by testing it here in my office using the app, I think I found myself a new light for my studio, either as a kicker or a background light to set the mood in here. This Panel Pro will be available at a discounted rate of $199 in their limited stock launch. Once those sell out, it's gonna be available in early December for $229. So you don't wanna miss out on saving some money. Click the link down below to see more on this panel. So let's go over the settings that I used in this video. The settings that I used were ISO 100, F3.5, and 1/200 shutter speed. And my intention was just to kill the lights that I have in my studio so it didn't affect my exposure. I used ISO 100 for the cleanest image possible. The only time that I don't use ISO 100 is when I don't have enough light available. I used F3.5 aperture. This is an F1.8 lens, but for studio work, you don't need to shoot wide open. I prefer to shoot at a smaller aperture so I can get more in focus and get more sharpness. The beautiful thing about this flash is that it can shoot high-speed sync, and I can use any shutter speed that I want. If I can, I would stay under the camera's flash sync speed because high-speed sync puts extra strain on your flash, and I didn't realize that on this camera it was 1/160th. So let's go over the gear used in this video. The speed light that I'm using is more than $100 because it uses a lithium-ion battery, but the one that takes AA batteries is $100. This adapter that I'm using is about $15. It is really an amazing product that you can use for other flashes as well as you start upgrading in power. It also has a Bowens mount adapter built onto it so that you can use bigger, nicer soft boxes along with a slot to mount the umbrella. This is the wireless flash trigger that I'm using that pairs up with the flash. You just want to make sure that the speed light and this trigger are on the same group and the same channel so they talk to each other. I always use my flash in manual so I can control the power of my flash myself, but you can use TTL if you'd like. If you hit this side button here, you'll be able to adjust the flash power using the jog wheel. For those who don't have thousands of dollars worth of camera gear, I hope that you can take the tips in this video and it'll help you take professional portraits no matter where you are. The links to the gear will be down below. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next tutorial.